Alright. Similar to last time. Burnt sienna, emerald green, ivory black, phthalo blue, lizard crimson, titanium white, cad yellow light, yellow ochre, Indian yellow, and naphthol red. We're going to do a barn today. Big barn. Big, big barn. Biggest barn I've ever painted, maybe. I don't know. How big do we want it? What perspective do we want? Lots of options here. Let's just start with the line and see where we end up. Okay. Okay. Might be a little too big. But we'll just keep going with this. That's a big barn. I don't really want it that straight either. Let's change our mind. Instead of making a straight line, let's make it come up this way. Something like that. It's a little bit better. This is an almighty bar. It's a big one. I don't want to go that high though, so you can come down here. And then maybe we'll put some trees up around it. Some on that side. Maybe on the other side. Put another tree line up here. There's a smaller one. Okay. Small shed here. A box. Let's see where we end up. Don't know why that sent two parts. We're having sometimes. YouTube does weird stuff. We just start painting here. Let's do a phthalo blue sky. Try to make sure there's no oil in this. Otherwise, I'm gonna have a bad time. Okay. Phthalo blue. Why not? Phthalo blue, how about you? Serve here. There we go. There's our sky. All done. Just kidding. Fender's here. Hey, Nate, what's up? Hey, Fender. How's it going? I haven't seen Billy in a while. I hope Billy's doing okay. Start with these back trees here, these ones, and work up a little bit, or maybe, let's see, I don't know what to do, too many ideas, not enough time. Let's do some clouds first though. I haven't done fan brush clouds in a good while. Let's do some of those. Let's just do a couple up here. A good bit of blue there. I don't really want these to stand out very much at all. These up a little bit. I really don't want them to. They're just like background noise, that's what I want. Kind of like that air conditioner. It's just got it there, but hopefully you can't hear it. Okay. Now let's do some big trees. Maybe not too big. Let's start with some smaller ones and then work up. So, we got green, some sienna. A little bit of crimson there. I'm gonna throw in some white. Oh, that's blue, whatever. These will be the far away ones, so they'll be back here. Big ones up here. Into grass. Right in here, down to here. Start on the barn. I haven't done any, started him yet. Paint Your Dream World's here. What's up? How's it going? Some of the crud off this brush. Put that down there. Let's get started on the big old barn. How do we want to do this? I gotta think. So it goes up here. I want the roof to be red. So, knowing that much, let's mix up some barn color. Burnt sienna and black. so let's go. Let's go. Extra, moving it around. Okay. There's a bit of a barn. Make this other side a little bit darker. I'm gonna actually add some. I'm gonna add some crimson on that side. Should be just a little bit. I don't know. Maybe there's a lot in there. This is the dark side of the barn. I wish that was right here. I'll fill in that gap there in a second. There won't be too much of this visible because we're going to put that tree right here. So, probably just the roof and this side there. I don't want to put it there with the tree going in because it'll just smear all over the place. Spots. Kind of straightening in some boards here, or what will be boards. I haven't put them in yet. Okay. And then we'll do the dark corners of the roof. I'm just gonna use that dark shadow color we made. I'll be doing that up here, right under the roof. There, a little bit over here. He comes off the edge a little tiny bit over there. Okay. I'm just gonna straighten him up a tiny, tiny bit. There we go. Especially over here. A little off the rails. All right. Let's highlight do the highlight on these first. Straight as I can down. So that's all I'm doing. those ones are too white. There. Okay, let's get this big old center beam here. You can do this with a flat brush too, or any brush really. Looks like my Aunt Naomi's barn. Only went there a few times when I was a kid, but they had a basketball hoop up in the top here, up in the in the rafters. For an old looking barn for you.
You need a palette painting knife.
Yeah.
Always screw up the roof line on my cabins.
It's tough. It's tough. I need like a what was that lady's name? The Helen Van Wyck. She has like a little metal thing that she it's like a big rod. She just has it kind of sitting up against this so she can paint easier. I need one of those. So otherwise my hand's like all over the place. Anyways, let's do the, I guess we gotta do this side. So let's do that side first. I'll take this color here. Add more of that dark. See too much of it. Oh, that's too. I say I don't want to see too much, and then I do that. So, let's go over it a few more times. There we go. That's our dark side. Okay. Make our roof of the barn, big old barn. This might be a little tricky because of the angle here, but we'll make it work. Just see the default red down here. And a little bit of crimson. I want it to be like a, not somewhere between crimson and naphtha red. We'll use naphtha red for the other side. Like over here, we'll highlight that one, but this one, this is gonna be in the shadow. Close. We got a little bit left. Wow. Down to the wire. I'm going to tap on it and make it look kind of different texture. Nope, I went too high. Now we really messed it up.
Just kidding.
We're good. Worst case, we just cover it with a tree, right? Okay. It's got paint all over my wrist.
Hey, check out Christian Jacquel, master painter from France. His palette work is incredible.
All right, I'll check him out. Thanks for sharing. Let's see. Gotta touch some on this side. That side of the bar. Connect the dot at the top. There we go. I think that should be fine. Hopefully. Get back here, we're just gonna throw in a tree anyway, so it don't matter too much. You need a door or something. Maybe some small windows. Some of those. I don't know what else we should put on here. Maybe a little thing across. A little plank of wood here. Frowny face. All right. Let's throw in some trees around him, and I think that should be good enough for this one.
It's like a sad face
got going on there. Kind of mix up all these colors. I don't know. Just all these colors just kind of mashed together. There we go.
Why does it have a face? Why not?
Personified barn. Okay. We gotta start putting in some grass type stuff here. So maybe we'll switch to more of a green undertone. A little bit of yellow. Well, not that much yellow. That was way too much yellow. Probably bust out the fan brush here after we throw in a big glob of this. Probably highlight the trees too. realized we didn't do that. All right, let's do that first. I'm gonna use some linseed oil. These different yellow colors. Don't really know which one yet. Maybe a little bit of all of them. I think this is Indian yellow. There's some mud in this brush already, so we'll see how it goes. See that side at all, so hopefully it doesn't look horrendous. Alright, this other side, I'm gonna make it kind of bright. Side to stick out a little bit more. Kind of like it's in front of the barn. The sun's able to hit him. There we go. Okay. Put in a little bit of a darker color before I do this, especially around this bottom part. Otherwise, I'm gonna stick out. I think this is just some sienna. Let's add in some tiny little highlights on the bush here. One here. Move it up a little bit here. Over here. Over here. Right there. Now I'm gonna start just tapping, but I gotta flatten it out first. Could also use the I might switch to the fan brush after I do this initial blob of yellows. There we go. Sorry if I'm missing anything in the chat. I'm locked in over here. Oh, dang, I missed a bunch of stuff. Do you work on social media? I don't know. Switching to oils, that'd be cool. Expression on the barn reminds you of cars. That would be funny. Make a barn series. Can't tolerate the fumes of oils. Yeah. Water mixables are pretty good. I used to use them a lot. I don't use them that much anymore. I just use what is that? I use Uncle 60 soap and the what is it? What's this stuff called? Bristle Magic. That's it. For Bob Ross, the water mixables are really good. It's hard to go wrong with them. So they don't really mess you up too much. They don't have that bad of a smell. The Lucas Berlin ones actually smell pretty nice. Alright, let's add some grass here. Actual grass. Texture. This is just the fan brush and some cat yellow. Trying to tap where I see hills, and then I'll smooth it out after I'm done. Kind of like that. And a little of that, and a little of that. Side. They take too long to dry. Yeah. They do take a long time to dry. That is a pain. Unless you get, what's that brand? Holbein Duo Aquas? Oh, they smell. They dry real fast, but they have like something in them that makes them smell like glue, rubber cement or something. Grumbachers dry pretty fast too, but they also have a smell. That's the kind that I use, or used to use. I don't really have much of them. I think I have a couple tubes left of them. Fat over lean. Yeah. Fat over lean concept is tricky. There was a Natural Pigments. That YouTube channel has a really good explanation video of fat over lean. They explained it like a brick wall, where if you add, the more oil you add, the binder in between the wall gets thinner and it doesn't hold together as strongly. I don't know how to apply that to my painting, but it's an interesting way of describing it. Super lazy. Some black and some umber or sienna. Because I can't see. Literally this entire block here is just a bright white blob. I can't tell what's going on right there. I hope it doesn't look too terrible. Okay. I'll just do some sienna and white. on the fan brush. Never unsee it. Okay, that's all I got for this one. Do a signature and then call it a day.
Move. Got scared.
Here we go. That's this one.